Okay, so to start with, you just want to draw around the spaces in between your fingers. Try to spread out your hand as much as you can while you do this, but don't do what I did here and re-spread once you start drawing. This will make the end product not as tight and kind of finished looking. You want to use a pencil to do this. It will make it so you can rub the markings off later. While doing this, you also want to mark each of your knuckles. Now you want to start joining your spaces together to create your web base. Now for this, you can either use the basic shape I created or get creative. There are heaps of shapes that could work with this. Use the dots you place by your knuckles to help place your web. Once you're pretty happy with how your shapes look, try putting your hand back on and off, looking at how the webs look, change things if you think you need to. Now you just need to carefully cut around all four of your webs. I numbered them so I could easily figure out what ones went where, but this isn't necessary. Carefully rub out your pencil marks and try not to crease your paper while you do this, because this will show up in your final piece. Get your liquid latex and pour a little bit into a dish of some sort. Take a baby wipe and give your hands a good wipe to get any oil and dirt off your hands. This will just help the liquid latex stick to your skin. Let your hands fully dry before adding any latex. To start adding the webs, you want to add a good layer of liquid latex to the insides of one pair of your fingers using a cotton bud. Carefully add your first web in between your fingers. Make sure you are happy with the placement, because for the most part it's not moving after this. Start strengthening your bond by adding another layer of latex on top of your joint, just on the top for the time being. Coat the whole web in a layer of latex, but careful and don't apply too much pressure. It will still be pretty fragile at this point. Once this is mostly dried, add powder. I just use baby powder, but you can use flour or translucent powder too. This will stop the latex from sticking together. Add more layers of latex on the top of the web. At the part where your two fingers meet, I like to create a bit of a V shape with the latex. This is purely for design purposes. Start adding the latex to the bottom of your web. Try to keep your fingers as far away from each other as you can while you're doing this, and powder it lots. It very easily sticks together and creates so much trouble. Make sure you coat the whole bottom side too. Coating the paper and not just the join is what gives this look movement, so it's an important step. Just keep adding more layers of latex and powder till you feel it is strong enough to move on to the next finger. Try feathering out the latex the further away from the web it gets. This will help it blend more into your skin. Repeat all this on the rest of your fingers. The reason I am only doing one or two webs at a time is so I can keep my fingers nice and stretched apart, and because they are very weak at first and it takes a bit of latex to build up their strength. Keep going back and forth and adding more layers to your first web as well. free to use a blow dryer on a low speed setting to help speed up drying time. I only recommend doing this after the first 1 to 2 layers of latex because then it will be strong enough to. The good thing about liquid latex is if you bugger something up and act quick enough, you can fix it. Here you see me just wipe away a V-shape and redo it because I didn't like what was happening with it. When you are almost done with all your webs, go through and check for any bits of latex that may have come up from your skin. Seal them back down with more latex. Once you have got a good amount of coats on each web, I would say at least 4 to 5, give it a good dry with the blow dryer and one last powder. Give it a good test and fix/add if it needs any more latex, then you are good to paint. For the paint job, you can do pretty much anything. I went with pink for this one, but for instance, I went with a sort of blue and black theme for my last one. I started off with a white grease paint to kind of start blending and prepping the skin for my pink paint. Depending on what you are doing with your webbed fingers will determine how far down your arm you will need to go with your paint job. To conceal any pencil/pen marks, I went in with some white grease paint on my finger and placed a thick layer on top of the marking just by dabbing it on. Then I powdered it and repeated that step a couple of times until the mark was completely gone. Now you want to get a cheap makeup sponge and rip little pieces of it. This will help create a non-uniform texture for the skin later. Taking a light pink grease paint, I went in and covered all the webs, blending it up onto the white, but not fully covering the white. I then took a dark pink shade and used the side of my brush to add some dark to just the edges of the webs. Do this on both top and bottom, using a sort of flicking motion. Take your pre-ripped up sponge and dip it into the dark pink. Dab and swipe this wherever you see fit to help give the skin some more texture and dimension. Then take the teal colour and do exactly the same thing. Take a black grease paint and add it to your nails. You can also use false nails to add an extra creepy effect if you want. Swipe the colour up the nails so it's a little lighter at the tips. Take your dark pink shade and start placing it in the creases of your hands and on top of whatever veins you can see. And there are your webbed hands. Feel free to take or add anything you see fit. And tag me/send me your work if you decide to have a go at this. I'd love to see it. Make sure you like and subscribe to see more like this, and I'll link my other social media down below. See you next time.